The Weed Seed Wizard is a computer simulation tool helping design weed management strategies in crops and improve yields. It can be used across Australia and fine-tuned to your or your client's farm using local weather data, soil type, and management options. It can also be used to manage weed species specific to your location, such as barnyard grass and sow thistle in the north, and wild radish and annual ryegrass in the south and west. This tutorial will take you through how to build your first scenario. When you first open the Weed Seed Wizard, the first screen you will see will be the Welcome screen. Press the New tab to open a new scenario. Then press Blank to open a new blank scenario. Go to the Scenario Setup window by pressing the tab on the top right-hand side. Select the start and finish dates for your scenario. Select your weed species and make estimates of seed numbers. Select the soil type. The wizard models available moisture in the soil profile from the weather to predict germination. Choose the soil type most suitable to your situation. Select the weather file pertinent to your farm or region from the weather files provided, or use your own weather file. Go to the Event Management window by pressing the tab on the top right-hand side. To add a management event, press one of the icons with a plus sign or the Management Event plus sign in the upper left-hand corner menu, and double-click the event type you wish to add. To add a till event, open the Add Till event, enter the date and the till type, and press Finish. Adding a sow event. Open the Add Sow event, enter the date, the crop you wish to sow, and the seeding type. Enter the seeding rate either as kilograms per hectare or as seeds per meter squared. You can also enter the viability of the seed if known. Adding a spray event. Open the Add Spray event. Enter the date and use the drop-down menu to choose a herbicide that is already listed. To add a new spray type for this scenario only, type the name of the new herbicide, in this case, New spray type, directly into the space. Choose the half-life of the herbicide over time if this is a residual herbicide. Choose the initial kill rate. This is the proportion of plants of this species that will be killed instantly upon application. Choose the residual kill rate. This is the proportion of new seedlings of this species that will be killed upon germination. This is for residual herbicides only. Go to Model, Add Herbicide. Type in the name of the new herbicide. Choose the half-life of the herbicide efficacy over time, the initial kill rate, and the residual kill rate as previously described. This new herbicide will now be part of the drop-down menu within Add Spray event. Make sure that you check the control percentage of the crop. Remember, if you have a 95% control listed for the crop after it has emerged, it will kill it and give strange results. Open the Add Harvest event and enter the date and the crop to be harvested. The wizard will predict the achieved yield with weeds by estimating how weed competition reduces the potential yield without weeds. There are several options for what this potential yield is based on. The wizard will assume an average potential yield. Enter a potential yield, for example, the average district yield. This will scale the average potential yield by a seasonal effect. This is the measured achieved yield and should only be entered in real situations with known numbers of weeds. Select a harvest type, In this case, default harvest, where 99% of the weed seeds were spread out the back of the header and dropped back into the seed bank. There are other harvest options, such as chaff cart and narrow windrow, and pre-harvest options, such as swathing and green manure. Change the percentage of weed seeds dropped for each species. Usually, this is 100%, unless you want the plants to keep on growing. Usually, 0%. The wizard will assume they germinate on the next rains as volunteers, if any, have dropped. Specify any yield reduction for this harvest. A volunteer pasture year is added like this. Open the Add Pasture event and enter the start and finish date of the pasture year. It is recommended to set the start date as the break of the season and the finish date when the plants are setting seed. Set the seed reduction by grazing, percentage of seed eaten or otherwise destroyed by grazing. You can also add a pasture rotation by sowing a pasture species and grazing throughout the year. Sow a pasture species, such as clover or cadis, using the procedure from adding a sow event. Open the Add a Grazing event and add the date, the percentage of the plants killed by that grazing event, and the percentage of the seeds dropped at grazing. You will need to add a few grazing events during the year. For the first few grazing events, simulate the grazing by reducing the number of plants and having no seed drop. For the final grazing event of the year, simulate the end of the season by having all the plants die or killed and a few seeds dropped, depending on the intensity of the grazing. Open the Add Plant Count event and enter the date and the count per square meter of each weed species. Most users will not use these events, and the model will run effectively without including any of these. Refer to the Weed Seed Wizard Build Your Own Scenario PDF for further information. Finally, press the Simulation tab, the green button under Model. Then go to the simulation window to see the yields, plant and seed numbers.